What's going on, world? This is Grandmaster FAQs, and this is another Partynerdz exclusive. Once again, going through the research of a lot of these movies, it tends to make you think. So, I was looking back at the first Guardians of the Galaxy movie, and of course, we're going to be introduced again to Ronan the Accuser in the next Captain Marvel movie. But we've already, of course, seen this character before in the first Guardians of the Galaxy movie. What kind of bothers me is the fact that in Guardians of the Galaxy, here you have Ronan the Accuser, who is a Kree. And he has fought himself a generational battle with the Skrulls. The Kree and the Skrulls have fought eons and eons for galaxies, and it's just been ongoing and ongoing. But Ronan has his eyes set on Xandar and the destruction of Xandar in the first Guardians of the Galaxy movie. So I'm thinking, at the end of this Captain Marvel movie, what sets his sights from his mindset of going through an entire generational war with the Skrulls and then setting his sights on the destruction of Xandar with the Nova Corps? What could have happened, and what are we going to foresee in this next Captain Marvel movie? Like, what is the correlation where this man doesn't even speak on his mortal enemy for an entire movie? You know, he's looking for Thanos' help to destroy Xandar. Now, is it for his own personal power or his own personal vendetta to close the deal on blowing up another planet in order to, like, prove a point? Or is there something there that the man wants? You notice when he got the Power Stone that he was like, all right, fuck it, I'll do it myself. What is on that planet that man wants? And it just, once again, got me thinking. Now, I've talked about it before, that the Kree, for the most part, might possibly be the purveyors of the Mind Stone. Now, a prerequisite of what may happen here is that could have ended up on Xandar, could the Nova Corps be the ones to aid Captain Marvel in defeating both the Kree and the Skrull in this next movie coming up? Does she look to the Nova Corps in order to make her move even that much mightier? Because you're figuring, yeah, she's the most powerful being out there, according to Marvel. But to destroy two mighty armies, it's going to take a lot more than just her. I mean, if she's going to handle this shit by herself, damn, this is going to look like a G-ass movie for someone of her capabilities to destroy not one, but two armies. So who's to say that she doesn't get the Nova Corps' help? But let me know what you guys think. All right, feel free to like, comment, subscribe to us at the Partynerdz YouTube channel. And I'll check with you again. All right, Partynerdz go. Partynerdz, 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 Partynerdz,